Hi children, let us continue with the tools of data handling. Mean, mode and range are the three tools that we have learned so far to handle data. Here are few situations. You have to find which tool will match to this situation. I will explain each and everything. You have to decide upon the number of chapatis needed for 25 people called for a feast. In a feast, do you think only elders will participate? No, there will be small kids too. Kids will eat one chapati or two chapati, whereas elders may eat up to 5 chapatis. Let us have an example for 25 people. These 25 people may eat different numbers of chapatis. One may eat one, the next one may eat three, next may eat two. One chapati is eaten by 5 people and 5 chapatis are eaten by 3 people. It is a scattered information. Which tool will you use to find how many chapatis is needed? Will you find mean? Very good children. If I have to find mean, I have to add all the datas and divide by 25. You will get few number. That multiplied by 25 will give you a right answer. Yes, you can use mean. But whereas mode, if this 25 people consist of many children, like 15 children, only 10 elders, 15 children will eat only 2 chapatis. If I find mode for that data, I will have only 2 chapatis as mode. And if I calculate only 2 chapatis for 25 people, will it be sufficient for all? No, it will not be sufficient for all. So, I should not use the tool mode when I come across this situation. It is advisable to use the tool mean and not mode or range. Hope it is clear, my dear children. Similarly, in this example, a shopkeeper selling shirts has decided to replenish her stock. Just now I discussed about this stock. Is it possible to use mean in this situation as I discussed in the previous video? No, it is not suitable to use the mean tool here. It is best to use mode here, which occurs many times. So, here I should use mode and not mean. So, my dear children, it is in the hands of statisticians to give the best tool to use in the proper situation. Okay, my dear children, in next class I will train you as to think like a statistician. Okay, we will do few project works in the next video. And today I have one special slide for you. What is it? Yes, here many students are standing in a line in front of their teacher. Which period do you remember when you see this picture? Excellent. I hope you will all think about PT period where you stand in line. Yes or no, my dear children? Very good. Even in max class, we do have activities in ground. Teachers ask you to stand in line to make two groups, two teams to play. How will your PT ma'am or PT sir arrange you into two teams? Will they give all the tall boys in one team and all short boys in another team? Will you accept for that? All friends together? Here one friends together? No, it is not a justifiable and a fair splitting of teams. We should have a fair two teams. How will ma'am do? Very good. Odd, even. Odd, even. Do we go that way? Yes. So, think about a situation where one in single student stand in the middle. That will give the central idea about the whole class, the height of that class. The center girl's height or center boy's height will give me the idea of height of the whole class students. So, we are going to introduce you a new mode called median What is it? Median. Say it. Median. This median is also another tool to handle data. So far we have learned 3. Include this median also along with that. So totally how many tools we have learned? 5. So median is defined as the middle observation of the data. Here this slide you have to write in your note. Okay, as I have given the symbol, writing note and pencil symbol, it is hidden behind my video. Okay, median refers to the value which lies in the middle of the data when arranged in an increasing or decreasing order. Okay, only after arranging we should consider the middle data. Without arrangement, if I consider a middle data and the shortest boy is standing in the middle, and if I say that is going to be the central idea, central or average height of that class students, will you all agree? No, it is not proper. So we have to arrange the data first. That is more much important in this tool. You have to arrange it, then you have to analyze which lies in the middle. So I can write median is equal to middle observation. It is written in short form. If they ask you as a definition, you have to write these 3 lines. Whereas as a formula in problems, you can make use of this statement. Shall we get into the problem, my dear children, now? A real life situation where we make use of tools to handle data. Okay, are you ready? Yes. Here again, PD period. So let us enjoy all PD periods in max class. Okay, along with mathematical tools. What are the tools we have learned so far? Mean, range, mode and median. Now, here the question goes. The runs scored in a cricket match by 11 players is as follows. The first player scored 6 runs. Second player scored 15 runs. Likewise, all the 11 players have scored many. Which is the highest score here? Very good, 120. Who has scored very less runs? Very good, 6. Now with this data, with this 11 numbers, with this 11 numerical values, I should find mean, mode and median. And I should say whether all the 3 values are same. We have to find 4 things. Mean, mode, median, and I should find whether all these 3 values are same. Okay. Shall we get into the solution now? Yes, come on. Take down in your note. We should first arrange the scores in ascending order. Instead of writing this whole statement, you can write in short as arranged data. That will also will make your work simpler. Arranged data. First arrange the data in ascending order, small to big. Start writing. Which is the smallest one? 6, 8, 10, 10, 15, 15, 15. 3 times 15 is there. Be clear. 50, 80, 100 and 120. I have written all the numbers. Every time check whether you have written all the 11 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. If you have missed one, check which one you have missed and fill it up. Without checking, don't proceed ahead. After arranging, you should check in median. Okay, shall we find? Mode is equal to, first I am finding the mode. Mode is defined as the observation that occurs highest number of times. Which number is repeating many times? Very good, 15. Just by looking at it, you will say me the answer. So mode is equal to 15. Okay, my dear children, now let us find what is median. I am writing this statement again and again for the reference, but you need not take down in your classwork note. This slide is also should be taken in your classwork note without the thing that is there on the top. Okay, what is median defined as? Median is equal to middle observation. Now be careful, my dear children. How many observations are here? 11. which one will be the middle observation? Middle, it should be middle. Which one? Very good. It is going to be the sixth observation. It is going to be the sixth observation. See here, right from here, if I start one, if I say one, here also one. Here two, here two. I have to find the middle one. Here three, here three. Here fourth one, here also fourth one. Here fifth one, here fifth one. Which one is in the middle? 15 is the middle. And which observation it is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th observation. So I can say median as 6th observation, which is equal to 15. Don't write median is equal to 6. Many students will make this mistake. You should not write median is equal to 6, my dear children. What is there in the 6th position? That is the median. So I can, in general, I can say, if the collection has odd number of terms, like 11, divide 11 by 2, I want two groups to be separated, divided by 2, 11 divided by 2, you will get remainder 1, 5 times you will get, 5 2s are 10, see here, I will get 11, 11 terms are there, I have to divide by 2, is 11 divisible by 2, no, I will get 5 2s are 10, and I will have remainder 1. So, after 5, you have to add this one. No need to add this one. Just to say, 5, after 5th term, 6th observation will be the median. So, you will have median is equal to 6th observation. Now, let us find mean for this. Mean is equal to sum of all scores divided by total number of players. This is very simple, my dear children. You have to work out this slide on your own because you are familiar with the tool mean. I have given you the answer 429 divided by 11. So you have to cancel it. 3 elevens are 33. Remainder, you will get 9. If I add along with this, I will get 99. So 9 elevens are 99. Okay, so the answer will be 39. Hope you got it. Now, then I have to check whether all the same. All are same. Here, they are not same. So, you have to conclude, no, the mean, mode and median are not same. Here is one special situation, my dear children. Find the mode and median of the data. These questions are there in your book. Okay. You have to leave space for the question and take down the solution alone now. First, I have to arrange the data. 12, 12, 12, 13, 13 here. This is broken. So, I have to write together. 12, 12, 13, 13, 14, 14, 14. From this, what is the mode? Mode is equal to observation that occurs highest number of times. Which is repeating many times? 14. So, mode is equal to 14. Similarly, median, middle observation. Okay, my dear children, which is in the middle? You should know now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Only 9 observations are there. If I divide 9 by 2, what will I get? 4 2s are 8. I will have remainder 1. So, this 4, after 4, what will I have? 5. Fifth observation is my median. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going to be the median. So, fifth observation is the median. Hope it is clear. Now, this is a special data, my dear children. I have to find the median. How many, first, what is the first step I should do when I use the tool day median? Arrange the data. Arrange the data first in ascending order. 17, 18, 24, 25, 28, then 35, 36, then 46. Hope you have arranged the data. Now count how many data? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 data now. 8 divided by 2. What will I get? 4. So 1, 2, 3. Will you agree this is going to be the middle data? No, my dear children. If I take this as the middle data, here I have 1, 2, 3, 4 observation. Here I have 3 observation. So, when you have even number of observation, you have to select these two, find the average of these two. Okay, add these two numbers, 25 and 28 and divide by 2 and you will get the answer. Hope you have learned.